In each episode of this series, I will offer an applicant a blind choice of either a pleasant experience, a treat, or a darker trick. They won't know which one they've chosen, and they may not know how or when it will happen to them. All the applicants responded to advertisements. These are the six people that I've selected. They just don't know it yet. Welcome to Trick or Treat. Tonight's applicant is a 29-year-old psychologist from Surrey called Jules. We follow Jules to North London, and while she's having a drink with a friend, we manage to get into her car, tamper with it so it won't start, and install this hidden camera in the dashboard.
She's in the stairwell.
Okay, Jules, stay in the car.
Oh, fucking hell.
So you volunteered to take part in the show?
I did.
We'd love to use you.
Okay.
What happens to you on the show depends on your choice of one of two cards. Now, one of them says trick, mm-hmm. and one of them says treat. All right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to play?
Yeah.
That's your contract, then, which you need to sign.
Okay.
Which allows us to do what we like with you.
Oh, right, okay.
Sign that down on the bottom on the right.
Mm-hmm. Here we go.
Thank you, Jules. Two cards.
Yeah.
One says trick.
Yeah.
And one says treat.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And I'll ask you to select either one. You're going to go for that one there?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now, I don't want you seeing which one you've picked. So I'm going to ask you to face that way for me and close your eyes as well so you don't see a reflection. Turn right round.
Mm-hmm.
Keep your eyes closed.
Yeah.
Good.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. You'll get a phone call within a couple of weeks and someone will come and help you start your car.
If they could, that'd be great.
More of Jules later. Covent Garden, actually a misspelling of Convent Garden, taken from the convent which used to overlook it, is an historic and lovely place to come and watch the performing tramps. We turned up one afternoon to try an exercise in crowd influence involving a Hessian bag.
You'll notice up above you is a Hessian bag. Inside the Hessian bag are 10 scrolls of paper. On each scroll of paper is written a word, all right? Now, you as a group are going to spell out a word letter by letter. I believe that I can make you spell one of the words that's written in the bag. Now, I'll be delighted if you spell any of those 10, but I'm going to try and push you to one in particular. Now, I need to choose one of you that I'm going to tell that word to, because one of you needs to be projecting that word to the group. I think, lady there, would you head up here for me? Excellent. What's your name? Liz, up your camera, Liz. Thank you very much. So Liz will have the job of projecting the word to you as a group. I need to tell Liz not only what the word is, but also how you're going to do that, to teach you, give you a little crash course in how best to do that. So we're going to lose my sound for a bit while I explain how that's done. Okay. Fantastic. First of all, before we go any further, you need, as a group, to sort of vote to elect a number between 1 and 10, all right? So if you can all just do that, just think of a number between 1 and 10, and we're going to take a vote, all right? OK, hands up if you thought of number 1, please. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. OK, that's a lot of you. 8, 9, 10. It was quite obvious to me, but that was number...
Seven.
Into the mic, please, if you don't mind.
Seven.
Seven. I hope you could all see that as well. That was quite a clear number 7. All right, fantastic. So number 7 has been chosen. Let me put that up here. Excellent. Liz, yes? Mm-hmm. You need to rest your head against that bit there, and I'm going to turn this on here. So, Liz, just in your mind now, just so you kind of get used to it, just begin to project that word over the heads of these people. Now, the rest of you, just take a look here in the centre and just take a moment to let different images and things go through your mind. And it's very important, Liz, that you keep an absolute poker face and just concentrate on sending that one piece of information. Now, we're going to try and spell a word as quickly as possible, a letter at a time, all right? So you are trying to spell a word. Now, I will tell you that the words in there and the words we're after are at least 5 letters long. So as soon as we come up with at least a 5-letter long word, that's when we'll stop. And we'll keep the image of Liz's eyes just sort of over the top of you while we do this. Somebody catch? S. Thank you very much. Throw it again, please. Not back at me, somewhere out there. Lovely.
A.
A. All right, go. Throw again. L. Okay, who's got that?
T.
T. E. Could have had salty. We now don't have salty. D. So we'll stop there. Liz, I'll ask you now to step away from the camera. Thank you, Liz, and let's just switch that off. All right, if you're happy that that was entirely fair, would you please give thumbs up? Excellent. All right, fantastic. Thank you very much indeed. What I need to do is just form a gap in the centre, so if you can kind of make as much space in there as possible. Thank you. Excellent. Okay, can we lower the bag, please? Okay, so I need 10 of you, ideally the people that spelt out the letters, and another 4. You're going to come forward, take out from inside the bag a scroll. Don't open it yet. If 10 of you can come forward, reach in. Take a scroll out and just hold on to it. When you've got one, please take a step back so that you can form a circle here facing inwards. Sorry, the last one? Excellent, thank you very much. All right, they're all numbered. If you've got number 7, please hang on to yours. Do not open it. Will the rest of you take the bands off, hold them up so we can all see the words that are printed on them, please. Excellent. You see, I lied. There were not 10 words written in the bag. There was only 1 word written in the bag, and that was on scroll number 7. Who's got number 7? Just hold it up. What's your name?
Chris.
Chris, come up here, bring it with you. Chris, great to meet you. Chris, put your bag down. Take the band off, but don't open it up yet. Okay, now what you're going to do, you're going to hold it like that. Don't open it yet. Okay, Liz, just take a step nearer the mic for me. Okay, now be honest, what was the word that you were trying to project to the audience?
Salted.
Salted, and there it is, you all got it. Go mad for Chris here and Liz, ladies and gentlemen.
I can't believe it, because it was such a random word. That's what surprised me.
When they were spelling out the word, I was just concentrating on it, and every time a letter came up, it was a letter I was concentrating on, so I was just spelling the word out to them. It was incredible.
You always think these things are set up, but it's now obvious to me that it really isn't set up. It's completely random and absolutely amazing.
At some point in the next 4 weeks, Jules will find out whether she's picked a trick or a treat. The covert camera we installed automatically records her whenever she's in the car. After watching her hands-free approach to driving during the first week's recordings, the idea for her trick began to take shape. Jules is going to have an out-of-body experience and witness her own death in a car crash. To make this possible, we needed a completely convincing double, and the only way to achieve that was to make an exact copy of Jules's face. We had to make that copy without her knowledge, and so we arranged for her to be invited to what was apparently a free spa treatment. She has no idea this has anything to do with us. She took the bait and made her way to our specially created beauty parlor, which we've rigged with hidden cameras. With the help of a Hollywood special effects expert, we embarked on a first in the history of prosthetics.
I don't know of anyone who's done this before, so a fantastic challenge and interesting to lifecast somebody without them knowing.
I'm keeping them closed. I'm just going to work over your eyelid now.
Is that necessary?
Yeah, it's a cooling mask.
The beautician is actually our own makeup artist, whose job it is to babble reassuring cosmetic nonsense to Jules and hide the fact that a big hairy American bloke is applying latex and plaster to her face.
Apply over your mouth now. Looking around your mouth. Right, I'm just going to start to work around your nostrils. The stubborn area with all the buildup of oil, and we'll sort you right out. It's just the tricky little bit. There we are. There we go. I'm just going to wait for this layer to set. Once this layer's all on, you'll start to feel this delicious warmth, and that's when the mask really starts to work. I think we've applied enough layers there, so we just need to massage this to make sure they gel together properly and let the mask do its job.
We've got a great cast. We've got a fantastic live cast. It will hopefully look as much like our subject as possible. So when she looks at this person, she'll be seeing herself, like looking in a mirror.
Jules has absolutely no idea what is about to happen to her. I would describe myself as driven, and when I say driven, I literally mean that someone drives me around, which is a very comfortable way of seeing all of you in your unusual families. Were I to ever buy a car, even just to use as an ashtray, I would absolutely choose to buy it from these guys.
Hi guys, so tell me your names.
Michael.
Michael, good to meet you.
Pleasure. Ruben.
Ruben. Darren, nice to meet you.
Diego.
Diego, very good to meet you. Thanks for doing this. Thanks for taking some time out. So listen, in England, car salesmen, particularly second-hand car salesmen, have a kind of a reputation of being bending the truth a little bit. Is it the same here? All right. Some people, obviously, not you guys, but certain people, other companies in this area. So, Diego, yeah?
Yeah.
If we took this car here, for example, I'm going to have you tell me four facts about it, but one of them I want to be a lie. Okay, now as it turns out, I don't drive, I don't know much about cars, but the lie needs to be something that's that I wouldn't just know, or that, you know, if you said it was blue, that's obviously a lie. Yeah, so try and make a lie one that would be very difficult for anybody to know, all right?
Okay.
Tell me fact number one about this car.
Fact number one about this car is that it comes fully equipped.
Fact number two, please.
Fact number two is that this is one of the sports editions.
Fantastic, thank you. Fact number three.
Fact number three, pretty much that it's an 8-cylinder.
Fantastic. And fact number four?
Fact number four, pretty much everything, all the types of controls you can maneuver it from the steering wheel.
Don't react. I was going to say it was three or four. Three or four were the only two. You were making very kind of open gestures on three or four. Three was the only one you were kind of nodding your head with a lot as well, which normally is a sign of overproving, you're telling the truth. I thought it was going to be four as well because you were making the same gesture, but you were too relaxed talking about things. Yeah. So I'm going to say number three was the lie, am I right? Yeah?
You hit it right there.
Oh, okay, cool. Yeah. Good start. Ruben, let's go with the red car behind you here. You know what the car is? You're familiar enough with it?
Yeah.
So, go, number one.
It's automatic.
Okay, it's automatic. Okay, that's right, we can keep each one simple, that's great.
It's a six-cylinder.
Okay, thank you. Fact number three.
It has leather.
Do you know what I'm going to say? It's fact number two, because you came straight in before I said number two. Yeah, is it number two?
Right.
It's not six-cylinder? Great, thank you very much. All right, IndyCar Mike, let's do the last one. Can we go with this car there? You know a bit about that one?
I know everything about that car.
You know everything about that car?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Same thing, four facts about the car, but I only want you to think each thing in your head.
Okay.
But still say them clearly as if you were saying them out loud. All right. Fact number one.
Okay.
Thank you. Fact number two.
Okay.
Fact number three.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And fact, it's the first one, isn't it?
Yeah.
Was that right?
It was.
The first one was the lie?
Yes, it was.
And it was something to do with the engine?
Correct.
Yeah? It's something to do with the engine? Yeah. I mean, I don't know what that was.
Although
you were saying stuff about numbers, you're kind of thinking numbers in your head, so I guess it's to do with numbers and types of cylinders or something like that.
You're absolutely right.
What was it? What were you thinking?
I was thinking of myself as a 4.2, when in actuality it's a 3.1.
I don't ever guess. Alright, thank you very much. Mike, that's fantastic. Excellent.
I thought I was pretty stone-faced. You know, I gave no indication that I lied about the first thing in my head. And before I even got to the fourth one, he pulled it out.
It's been over 4 months since Jules applied to take part in the show. Since then, she's been through a psychological evaluation to ensure that she was robust enough to take part in Trick or Treat. Jules's trick is about to begin. She received a phone call telling her she was required for a photo shoot for the series. She was told to drive alone and to wear the outfit that she'd been sent. In the 3 weeks since Jules unknowingly chose a trick card, we've made a deathly mask of her face without her knowledge, which can now be placed on an actress of similar build. We've also cast some actors to play various parts in her unfolding nightmare. They've all been briefed to ignore her. Finally, there is a psychologist standing by should Jules require aftercare. All these elements will now be brought together in a cordoned-off section of the Berkshire countryside. All the cameras remain out of sight. Jules is about to wake up fixed to the floor and staring at her own car with her dead self in the driving seat.
Standing by.
Oh my God.
Shit.
Hello? What the fuck is going on?
Shit. Hello? Hello? Hi, I've been in an accident. Thaxton Road and Bearglass Way.
Hello? Hello?
I'm okay, but I think the other person's really hurt. Thanks. Okay. Shit.
Excuse me. What? Hello? Hello? Jesus Christ. What the fuck is... No, 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 no.
I'm all right. It's the lights aren't working, so I
the lights weren't working.
And next thing I know, she's gone in to meet him.
Fucking hell.
When I woke up, she was.
Okay, just do us a favour. Can you just sort of rest yourself against the slope there? Just rest yourself there.
Hello, excuse me.
She wasn't moving at all.
Okay, where do you live?
London.
Whereabouts in London?
Camden.
Okay. What does it say?
I should have done something. I didn't really know what to do. I think.
What is going on? Jesus Christ. Hello, excuse me. Hello. Hello.
How old are you?
Hello.
I'm 25.
Fucking legs.
I just got into a crash
and
I'm fine. I'm absolutely fine.
Tell me what's
happened. Right, we've got one female unconscious head injury and all seems spinal, funny collar and full trolley cock blaze. Can you hear me?
You can't move her, mate.
She's not responding.
You could cause more damage to her, so...
Just going to pop you on some oxygen.
No. This is not funny.
Oxygen on. Don't be too long, my love, okay?
Hello?
No, probably not long.
All right, just get her hair, mate.
I just feel like I could have done something.
Slide.
She didn't say anything, she didn't move.
I've got
the
leg. I've got the head.
She didn't look good at all.
If you offer to go to the head, I'll come around side. Just lift up onto the cot.
When
you're ready, go.
Mind my back.
Two, three.
Oh, Jesus.
And round.
Spin round.
Spin round. Thanks so much, mate. Grand job, everyone.
So, was it what? How far did you travel, would you say?
Blues all the way, mate.
30? Yeah, less probably.
Sort of speed reduced to say she was doing.
Really close.
Do you want to get in the back of the car now?
They don't have the siren on unless they're alive, do they? There's no point.
Well, it's, it's
an accident. I believe it.
All accidents are like that.
Oh, so, Jesus, what's going on? Oh, God. Oh, God.
Tonight's Trick or Treat and the pick of this week's programmes are available to watch online absolutely free. Go to channel4.com/4OD. Next, will Mark leave Jeremy all alone for the sake of Sophie, the woman of his dreams? Peep shows next on 4.